In this video, I'll be introducing the idea of significant figures. Watching this video is one step toward meeting the objective of reporting measurements and answers to calculations with the correct number of significant figures. In the lab, there may be multiple instruments that can be used to make a particular measurement. Let's say that you want to measure the temperature of a liquid. You may have access to a digital temperature probe or perhaps an alcohol thermometer. These provide different measurements, but which is correct, or is either correct? To answer these questions, we have to consider the idea of uncertainty. Every measurement has a different level of uncertainty associated with it that may be influenced by the instrument itself, the person performing the measurement, or other factors. Let's say that your temperature probe gives a measurement of 77.0 degrees Celsius. In this measurement, the first three digits are certain, meaning there is no ambiguity or uncertainty associated with them. The last digit, however, is estimated, and this is referred to as the uncertain digit. The reason for this can become clearer when looking at the example of the glass thermometer. When looking at the measurement shown in the red bar on the right of this picture, you'll notice the measurement is between 77 and 78 degrees Celsius. The actual value of the measurement could vary depending on who you ask. Somebody might say, oh, that measurement is 77.6 degrees Celsius, or somebody else might say that measurement is 77.7 degrees Celsius. This is why the first two digits on this measurement are certain. We know for certain that the temperature is at least 77 degrees Celsius. However, the last digit is estimated. We could say this last digit is a 7, or a 6, or a 5, or an 8, depending on who you ask. In the case of these two instruments, the thermometer probe contains more significant digits and is thus more certain. The alcohol thermometer contains fewer significant digits and is thus less certain. When determining which significant figures are significant, we can use a set of general guidelines. All non-zero digits in a measurement are considered significant. In both of these cases, each measurement contains three significant figures, three non-zero digits. Furthermore, trailing zeros to the right of a decimal are also considered significant because they indicate the amount of certainty within a given measurement. For example, this number, 0.70 centimeters, contains a different number of significant figures than 0.7 centimeters. These numbers represent different levels of accuracy. The number 0.70 centimeters has two significant figures, while 0.7 centimeters only has one. Zeros between non-zero digits are also considered significant, as shown in these two examples. An important subclassification here is that trailing zeros to the left of a decimal place are significant if there are zeros found after the decimal. And again, that's because all trailing zeros to the right of a decimal are significant. So this is a subclassification of the zeros shown underlined here, which are significant. Now we can classify all other digits as non-significant. Let's be specific though, starting with leading zeros. Leading zeros are always non-significant. Trailing zeros to the left of a decimal, if lacking a significant digit following the decimal, are also non-significant. For example, 750 milliliters only has two significant digits. Here, pause the video and check your understanding by determining how many sig figs are in the following four measurements. I highly recommend writing down these examples in your notes so that you can refer to them later. On the next slide, I'll discuss these examples one by one. For these four measurements and all values, it can be useful to express the value in terms of scientific notation to help determine the correct number of significant figures. That's how I'll be treating these four examples, but you can also use this in conjunction with the rules we discussed on the previous slide. Either of these strategies will work. In the first measurement, we can move the decimal 4 places to the right to express the value as 9 times 10 to the negative 4 millimeters. When considering a number in scientific notation, all digits to the left of the multiplication sign, in this case the 9, are significant. Therefore, this value has one significant figure. When considering the next value, we can move the decimal place 4 places to the left. This gives a value of 1.54500 times 10 to the 4th grams. Again, everything to the left of the multiplication sign, all of these underlined values, are significant. So this value contains 6 significant figures. In the next example, the measurement contains 5 significant figures. And lastly, here's an example with 4 significant figures. Remember that this 0 that's between the non-zero digits, this 3.042, this 0 is considered to be significant. Going back to our measurement for the digital probe, we can put this into scientific notation. We can clearly see that the measured value contains 4 significant figures. For our alcohol thermometer, we can see the measured value contains 3 significant figures when putting it into scientific notation. When performing calculations with different measurements, we need to consider 2 major rules. One applies to multiplication and division, which we'll discuss first, and the other applies to addition and subtraction. It's important to remember that if you have multiple operations, such as multiplication and addition, you'll follow both of the rules following the order of operations, always starting with multiplication and division, second, addition and subtraction. The answer you get for your calculation will have the same number of significant figures as the starting quantity with the least number of significant figures in the case of multiplication and division. This may sound confusing, but let's go through an example. If you have a 5.80 gram sample of lead that occupies a volume of 0.5114 centimeters cubed, we can calculate the density of lead in grams per centimeters cubed by considering the number of significant figures in both of these measured quantities. The mass, 5.80, contains 3 significant figures. The volume, 0.5114 centimeters cubed, contains 4 significant figures. To calculate the density in grams per centimeter cubed, we need to divide the mass by the volume. When you do that, your calculator will spit out a value, which is 11.3 with all of these additional numbers, grams per centimeter cubed. Now, it's silly to report the measurement with this degree of certainty, as in all of these digits after the decimal place. And this is because the mass and volume, based on the mass and volume given, we can't actually determine the density value out to this many decimal places, out to this degree of certainty. Based on our measurement with the least significant figures, again, because we're dividing here, we need to follow this rule at the top for multiplication and division, our mass has the least number of significant figures. So therefore, we will need to round this value to 3 significant figures. When doing this, we'll round to the tenths place, and that 3 will remain as is because it's followed by a 4 in the value. So this gives us an answer of 11.3 grams per centimeter cubed. Again, that you might say, well, these numbers are the same, but they're actually not. This number only has 3 significant figures, 11.3, and that's the correct number of significant figures based on the measurements. For addition and subtraction, it's necessary to focus on the number of significant digits after the decimal place for each of the values that you're either adding or subtracting. For example, if we're adding up these juice temperatures from 3 unique measurements, we can consider the digits after the decimal in each measurement. In the case of 4.1 degrees Celsius, this measurement only contains 1 sig fig after the decimal. in the second measurement, two significant figures after the decimal. And in the third, three significant figures, again, after the decimal. For addition and subtraction, we're always looking at the number of digits after the decimal. When we add these up, your calculator will show a value of 12.550 degrees Celsius. Again, just because your calculator says that doesn't mean it's appropriate to report all of these digits based on the measurements. When adding and subtracting, we need to consider this, the measurement with the least sig figs following the decimal. That will be our first measurement, which only goes out to the tenths place. You can see that I've underlined the tenths place here to indicate that we will need to round at the tenths place when reporting our sum. When we round, that gives us a value of 12.6 degrees Celsius. Because the tenths place here, 12.550, the tenths place is a 5, the digit that follows is a 5, so it's necessary to round up that tenths place to a 6, which is why our reported measurement is 12.6 degrees Celsius. Now let's say you were to calculate the average value of these three temperature measurements, meaning you'll add all the values up and divide by the number of measurements. In this case, there are three. Now, you would divide the sum by 3 because there are 3 unique measurements. Now you might say, well, this is division and I'm dividing by 3, which only has one significant figure. But it's actually important to consider that 3 in this case has an infinite number of significant figures because it's an exact value. 3 measurements. That's not a measured quantity, it's an exact value. That means we might as well be dividing by 3.00000 and so on. So when we divide our sum by 3, we get a value on our calculator of 4.1833333 infinite threes. And notice that I've underlined the digit here that we need to round to the tenths place based on our addition operation that we did on the previous slide. When we round this value, we get 4.2 degrees Celsius, which would be the reported average of these three juice temperature measurements. Now, importantly, much like the number of measurements, conversion factors are almost always exact quantities as well. For example, when we see the conversion factor, 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 meters. This actually means 1.00000 infinite zeros kilometers are equal to 1,000.0000 meters. So again, an infinite number of significant figures are associated with the values in this conversion factor. That, in other words, there's exactly 1,000 meters in exactly 1 kilometer. When you're determining the sig figs to report in a particular calculation, if you use a conversion factor, the number of significant figures in that conversion factor are generally ignored for this reason. So it's most often the case that you'll be looking at the measurements in the provided information itself about the problem versus the conversion factors that you're going to use when determining the number of significant figures. This video has introduced the idea of how to report measurements and answers to calculations with the correct number of significant figures. Thanks for watching.